The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 persons with leprosy met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Be seated, my brothers and sisters. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. Today we gather to thank God in a special way. Today we gather in a way to count our blessings and show an appreciation and come before our God with gratitude for his love, for his kindness, for his mercy towards us. So many a time we are just like the 9 other lepers who feel when we receive what we ought to, that God is entitled to give it to us. And as such, we don't even acknowledge the need to say, "Thank you, Jesus." So many a times, all we do is to whine and complain on the things we ought to get, but we don't have them. Many a time we only go to Jesus only in time of need. Many a time we make promises to him, "Lord, if you do this for me, I will do that for you." It sounds like as if we are playing game with the Lord of life. As if both of us are, we are the same creatures, forgetting that he is the creator, and there's no how we will be the creator. We will never cease to be the creature. And then being a loving father, being a God who always has mercy and who always listens to the petitions of his children, many a time he gives us that which will lead us to him. But then when he does his part, we on our part behave like the 9 lepers we heard in today's gospel. So many a times we are in trouble. So many times we are faced with different difficulties and hardships in life. We have made so many promises to God. When those things come through, do we keep to it? Or do we say, "God, I'll see you next time, I'm stuck. You've done your part, thank you so much. I will come back to you again next time I'm in trouble." What are we thankful of? That's the first question we need to ask ourselves. That we go to bed, we wake up, we sleep, and wake up is a miracle. That every morning you and I get up, stretch our hands and feet without any headache, without any body ache, is a miracle. That you and I have a breath of life is a miracle. And for those reasons, you and I need to go on our knees and say, "Thank you, God, for your love towards me." There are so many of us that started this year, but today they are no more. Not because of their sins, Not because God do not want them to live longer. Not because of any merit of theirs or whatever they have done wrong that they are no longer here today. But it's by special grace of God that each and every one of us live each moment. Brothers and sisters, the question we ought to ask ourselves is, are we thankful people? In my life, do I show appreciation? In my life, am I grateful to God for his countless blessings? In my life, how do I live it? Do I live as if there is nothing called God? Do I even have a personal relationship with my God? Do I even understand that this life belongs to him, that I'm only a caretaker? That each decision I make in life has eternal consequence, either for him or to the other side of the coin. Who are we? Something each and every one of us, we need to ask ourselves. Who am I? Do I live my life in a manner that shows that appreciation, that shows that gratitude, that shows awareness of God's presence in my life? Is that who I am? Or do I live that there is no tomorrow? Do I even think of eternity? Should anything happen to me now, what will my end goal be? Do I even have a goal in life, knowing fully well that at the end of life, that this should be my portion? And if I do, what are the decisions I make in life to accomplish that end goal? Brothers and sisters, 10 people were cured. 10 people were cleansed of their leprosy. Only one saw the need to be grateful. You and I might point accusing finger to the other nine. But if we are to look our lives in the mirror, if we truly, truly need to be sincere to ourselves, we discover that we are no better than the nine who never return back to God. And so today, one of us has realized all the different waves of life, all the different obstacles of life, all the different things that she on her own would not have accomplished. He recognized the hand of God in her life, in her family's life, and said, you know what? I will be like this one leper who returned to give thanks. I will dedicate a day in thanksgiving to my God for his countless blessings, even when she doesn't even merit his blessings. Brothers and sisters, a model for us to follow, a model for us to imitate, to be thankful. Yes, 10 of them were cleansed, and Jesus in his love and mercy never said, you know, to the other 9 who never returned, you know what, your leprosy will continue. No, he never took back his healing. He never took back his mercy. But the one who returned to give thanks got more. Look at what he said to him. Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you. Not only he was cleansed, but also he received the gift of salvation. In other words, brothers and sisters, when we live in gratitude, when we live each day thanking God for his countless blessings, for his countless mercies, for the love he showers on us, even when we do not deserve them, when we show those appreciation, he continues to bless us. He continues to clear the way. There are so many things he does for us, but because they do not come right before our face, we don't understand that his hand is at work in our life. So many times, let us retreat and take a look back at our lives. You will see so many hurdles in our life that you ask yourself, how did I manage to get over there? How did I manage to get over those difficulties? It is the hand of your Heavenly Father who loves and cares for you. Brothers and sisters, his love has no comparison. But what can we give in return? What can we give in return for his countless blessings? Let us return in thanksgiving to our Heavenly Father. Let us crawl on our knees and beg him for the many times we did not know him. Let us beg him for the times we've been so selfish and so centered. Let us beg him for the times we have taken the glory that belonged to him to ourselves. Let us, you know, beg him for the many times we have in place of serving him, we have served ourselves. Let us resolve to be a grateful children of his, that he may continue to clear the way, that he may continue to bless us, so that brothers and sisters, at the end of it all, each and every one of us here present will hear those wonderful words of our Lord. Stand up and go, for your faith has saved you.
Hands, everybody, come on.